All right, Lowell, are you ready for it? Are you ready for the premiere episode of the Lowell Train? Well, we're here. We're ready for it. And we're just waiting on you to sit down and shut up. The LTC Sessions is no more. Lowell Train has rolled into town. We have 15,000 horsepower running this show, along with the electronic experience. First time ever on the show, because it's the first show ever, Lowell Train. Thank you. All right, we're going to take a little break. Everybody's going to sit down, shut up, and just calm down. We're going to watch some videos that have been done on site, and then we're going to roll into an interview with Mike Tessa and the rest of the boys in the band, the Electronic Experience. Hey, don't go nowhere. Just do what I tell you. Lowell Train, Maximus Sack, coming at you. Thank you.
How's it going? My name is Mitchell Simillion, behind the scenes with the artist at Lowell Train. Today we're with Mike Testa and we're with Dan Tang. Dan Tang, how's it going?
Good, yourself?
Great, great, great. Mike, how's it going today?
Doing awesome, doing awesome.
I'm
good to see
you. Guys' hand, you know, for the record, right? So how's it going today? I'm excited to have you guys on set.
Oh, thanks, dude.
I've heard you guys' music and I love it. I don't know, are you guys co-producing this album? Did you guys, the Ace?
Yeah, so this is a new project that we're just starting out. We're calling it the Electronic Experience. So Dan and I have known each other since college.
College.
Yeah, so freshman year of
college.
Long
time ago.
Yeah. The best meeting grounds, if you guys ever need some advice, you should meet somebody in college.
Yeah. I met a lot of people. Yeah, I met a lot of people in college.
Right.
I still meet a lot of people in college.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Great space.
We won't talk about that.
You actually work at a college.
I work at Salem State University.
Salem State University. Yeah. Salem State University.
Holla.
How do you like it over there?
Love it. It's awesome.
Do you teach history, chemistry?
No, music technology.
Music technology.
Yes.
Wow.
We
sounds like rocket science.
Sometimes it is.
I believe it.
Yeah.
Believe
no, it. He's the rocket scientist.
Not so. It. All right. So the Electronic Experience, is that an album that's coming out? Is that a genre? How do we explain that?
I got this one. So it's It's an avant-garde type of music. So if you think back to the days of like when people were, like the Beatles were doing crazy stuff with tape machines and crazy stuff with electronics, we're sort of taking that to the next level. And there's a lot of artists out there doing it already.
Of course.
So, you know, for us, we're putting a little spin on it where we're using more homemade items like what we have in here. We haven't come up with a name with it yet. It's the hydro synthesizer.
I heard something like that, and I like it.
Yes.
I've never heard of it before, and I really hope you guys coin it tonight on the Lowell Train show.
Totally. This is the debut of it, actually.
So. Is it really?
Yep.
So we're in for a treat.
Totally. We're going to play this next.
So. Okay.
But the idea is that you fill it up with water, and as the water rises, it starts playing sounds. So.
So the higher it goes, we get different notes.
Right. You got it.
Now that's rocket science. No, that's rocket science.
He's the rocket scientist.
Is it your idea? Who do we
find? This is a brainchild. Well, I think this is a bit of a joint notion.
Totally.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So he came up with the idea originally. What were you going to do originally?
Something that had a little bit less tinfoil.
Oh.
And more.
Well, I took it off of
my hat. So.
No, I mean originally I was going to do actually the opposite. I was going to empty the water.
Oh, okay.
And as the water level went down, we were going to make different sounds or different beeps or what have you.
Wow. So it's almost like a...
But now we're filling it up and going the other way.
Yep. I don't know how we're going to turn it off, though.
For some reason, I get R2-D2, but it has no resemblance.
No.
Forgive me for the Star Wars fans out there.
No, it doesn't beep quite
the same way. Your favorite robot, but I definitely get that feel.
I was more of a 3PO fan, so...
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Then you
maybe
get no offense.
Like the shiny metal.
Right, right.
Yeah. Hmm. I mean, R2-D2 just kind of like stood there.
Stood
like,
and...
You know, shot. Yeah, exactly. Like, you know.
Didn't really do much.
Yeah.
So it's definitely correlative to the electronic experience. The electronic experience, that's definitely where we're going with the sound. I definitely love the sound. I don't know, is it AC?
APCP. So that was APCP. Yeah, that was the last album that I wrote. It's more in the ambient chill genre.
Right.
But the idea is that, you know, there was a lot of science involved. So for those of you that are scientists out there, APCP was the rocket fuel that they used. It's a solid state rocket fuel.
Wow.
So the album is very much based around...
Physics
and science.
Right.
In fact, one of the pieces takes actual photos of the planets and then transfers the wavelengths down into the audible spectrum, and you can hear it. So
really?
It's called Cruising on Impulse Power.
Wow.
As an ode to Frank Zappa.
Wow.
For cruising for cheeseburgers.
So different propulsion systems. We're dealing with different propulsion. This is rocket science. I love
Dude,
it.
It's
I haven't heard that backstory. That's
yeah,
that's a
so
backstory.
I love Frank Zappa, and one of my favorite songs is Cruising for Cheeseburgers.
Right. Now, not to go on a different tangent, just the fact that you said that, I seen a TED Talk presentation where a blind person had a camera, and that camera allowed him to receive colors into sound.
Cool.
No way.
So that is
That's
actually
cool
you guys are definitely avant-garde when it comes to engineering.
Sound, well, it's the type of stuff, man. Like when you look at instruments like this, I mean, the real world has so many different possibilities, so many things you can sense and see and experience somehow. And what we look to do is turn that type of stuff into song.
We need it. So, are you guys gonna kick us into the next step with this thing? What do we call it? We call it the hydro synthesizer.
Yeah, we're gonna patent it right now, man.
Patent it right now?
Totally.
This is history. You guys can't copy this after this. This is, I hope you guys know, this is live history being made. So how do we get it started? Do we get water in here or?
Yeah, so we'll throw some water in here.
All right.
And then as we'll fill the bucket up, it'll play different notes depending on where the water is.
So there's four different levels here, five?
Yeah, something like that. So, and then it goes to that really awesome thing up front called a makey makey. Yep. Which is, it's an Arduino-based thing. So a dude from MIT actually developed this thing. And it's really cool because it basically interfaces with any sort of digital audio workstation like GarageBand, Ableton, Pro Tools.
Reaper. I love Reaper.
Love Reaper. I'm a Reaper guy.
He's a Reaper guy.
You're a Reaper guy?
Right,
pounded right here.
Love it.
Reaper.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Wait.
Ableton.
So, open source everything.
Yeah, I use Ableton. I'm sorry.
Right.
But the cool thing is that it's a proto board, so you can pretty much hook anything that has a connection up to it, and it'll work with any of those software. So it's a huge prototyping thing. And we're using it a lot for music education, too, especially in K-12 systems where, you know.
Thinking outside of the box. Hence
legit.
The box.
Right. So
that is the way to go.
Yeah. With this, you know, kids can make their own instruments and be involved with music.
Right.
And it's a really cheap alternative to instruments, you know, traditional instruments. Right. But it allows students to explore the science side and the technology side as
well. Right, right. Giving an avenue before we even get to college because, you know, so many times we see people going to college, we don't know what we want to do. But if you've been a creative and you know how to think outside the box, you're right above the line. You're right there.
You're
avant-garde.
This guy.
So we're here with Mike Tester, Dan Tang, and we're going to take a short break, and we're going to see how this thing works. The hydro synthesizer. This is Lowell Train, Mitchell Semillion. Coming back to you.
Thanks for the help.
Global Train. Yeah, we're done with watching the videos. We're done with watching the pre-recorded stuff. We're live. It's the third Thursday of the month. Lowell Train is coming at you live tonight with the electronic experience. So I'm just going to shut up for once and let them take it. I don't care. Thank you. We got through another Lowell train, or we got through a Lowell train. We got through another show. I'm done. I'm going to Uncharted Gallery now. I want to thank everybody that showed up on the crew. I want to thank Alec. I want to thank Aaron. I want to thank Mitchell, Steve Bickford. I want to thank our sound engineer, wizard that he is, Patrick Meany. I want to thank the Electronic Experience. I want to thank Steve Maddock. I want to thank Britt Bogner. I want to thank myself, because I dragged myself down here just for you people, just for you people in Lowell, just for you people everywhere in the world. We were live this month with the Electronic Experience. You are watching Lowell Train. Remember it.